Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's CJ, right-hand man to the number one motivational speaker in the world, Dr. Eric Thomas. That's right, ET. Listen, man, if you've been on social media, you've probably seen the wave, all right? School Days is going down. He's been in schools across the country, just saving students, helping them get to that next level, eliminating high school dropout. And listen, man, for the first time ever, we're doing a gala. I shouldn't even call it a gala. It's a party slash fundraiser slash come hang out. Just an event, man, down here in Atlanta, Georgia, and we want to invite you to be a part of it, all right? The event is on September 1st, 2018 at the Georgia World Congress Center. It's going to be at 6 p.m. Listen, we got celebrity guests coming through. We got entertainers. We got musicians. We got athletes coming through. It's going to be an amazing event, and it's going to be just an amazing night. So listen, man, go to saving7000.com, all right? Saving7000.com and register, and we want to see you down here in Atlanta, man, to hang out with us. Have a great night. And most importantly, man, save these students, man. You know, that's ET's passion. Help us help ET win that Nobel Peace Prize. All right, we'll see you on September 1st. Oh, did I mention it's also ET's birthday? Shh, don't tell anybody though. It's ET's birthday, so we also gonna have a birthday celebration at the same time. So come hang out, wish ET a happy birthday, and help some students out. Thanks, guys.
I'm a learner for real, like not just schoolwork. Like, I just pay attention to everything. So I'm in Dubai, and we did the podcast, but I didn't bring my computer with me because I promised my wife that it wasn't going to be that kind of trip, right? So I'm like, if I bring my computer, though, she's going to think it's going to be that kind of trip, right? And we're going to end up getting into it, right? So my wife was like, we're going to Dubai. We're going 2 weeks. You ain't doing no work. I'm like, bet, I got you. No computer. So I brought my little recorder though to do the podcast, and it's got like a SIM card like in it, and then you got to take that card, put that in the computer, and then you send it, right? So I was like, some kind of way, this Dubai, I heard about Dubai, it's supposed to be all that in the bag of chips, they got to have an Apple store. So I put my joint in there, right? And what was the problem? Like, it fit, everything worked, but what was the problem with the store I was in? Okay, yep, but a connection, but what kind? No, it was a connection, internet connection, but it was what? It was weak. So I was sitting there for like 40 minutes. It was like 3%. I'm like, this ain't gonna work. My girl like, I thought we wasn't gonna, you gonna want me, you doing no work. You were here for 40 minutes. I'm like, oh, this, okay, I'm out. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, abandon ship, abort that boy. So I go to the concierge like, bro, I need to, and I listen to me. This is why I tell y'all for real, like, you can't be average and think you're gonna make your dreams become a reality and you're gonna be paid and you're gonna live life happy. It don't work like that. So I go to the first girl, she tell me what? She said, nope, we don't know how. I'm like, all right. I go to the next young lady, she told me what? She can't do it. Now these were the two people, listen to me carefully. These were the two people who worked behind the desk. My man came out, my man was sitting on the side with a suit on. You thinking people just get jobs because they get jobs, right? That's what you thinking, right? But I went to the first person, she told me no. I went to the second girl, she told me no. My man with the suit on the back looking suave. My man said, what you need? I love it. Like, that's why my man getting paid more than they getting paid. Listen to me very closely. When you graduate and you get a job, if you want to get paid, you never say no. You never say it can't get done. Don't you ever say out your mouth it can't get done. Even if you feel in your heart it can't get done, you don't say it out loud. You let the broke folks say that. You let the folks they firing first say that. You always say it can get done. Even if you don't think it can get done, just say it and try to make up something. I'm being real. Let me tell y'all something. When y'all graduate and y'all start working for folks, and they can tell you just there to get paid, you're gonna be out of there quick. You don't take no ownership, you're gonna be out there quick. You're gonna be gone. My man walked out like, yo, what you need, bro? I was like, I got it, whatever. He's like, okay, we got a computer over there, we selling it, but, you know, so I don't know if you want your stuff on there, but if you don't mind your information being on the computer, it's all good, go for it. I'm like, bet. My man talking to me in English, and it's a sweet English, but I could tell that ain't his first language, though. He was from India. So he was rolling with me, but a couple of them I had to stop and hear what my man was saying. I was like, all right, boom, got it. So then I noticed that an older Indian man came in and he was flowing with homie. And then I noticed somebody that was from Dubai who spoke Arabic came in and my man was, boom, answering their question. I'm like, my man, that's three. I'm like, that's three right there. My man, just in a couple minutes, he did the English boy, got me what I wanted. He was talking to the older dude from India. An Arabic family came in. My man went boom, boom, boom. Then somebody Latino came in. My man started speaking Spanish. I was like, ah, what is happening in front of me? Pulled my man to the side when it slowed down. I was like, homie, you, how many languages you speak? He said, I speak six. I said, what school you go to when you was little? He told me. I was like, so they just teach all them languages? He's like, no, nobody, they only taught us one language in India. We don't learn six. I was like, well, when you learn the other four or five? He was like, oh, when I moved to Dubai 4 years ago. I was like, you learn four or five languages in 4 years? He was like, yeah. I was like, how? He's like, it's the only way you eat. He's like, if you only speak one language, you outside with like the masses, like in 180 degree weather. It's the desert. It's hot. He like, you out there with them, and all they doing is building buildings. That's all they do. And you can see it. Like when you leave a resort, you can see like buses and groves. And they on the buses and groves, and they shipping them to do construction work. My man in the five-star resort living live. I'm like, how do they live here? He's like, well, don't believe the hype. Everybody tell y'all how sweet it is, but most of them live in 6 to 7 to an apartment. But me and my roommate, we live together. I said, why? He said, we speak four languages so we can work at the resort. Y'all hear what I'm telling you? Don't be average. So I want you to ask yourself, and we're going through this, the problem with privilege. I want you to ask yourself, do you have a spirit of entitlement? You got dreams and goals, but you entitled. The problem I have with most kids, if I tell you what it takes, most of you will die of exhaustion. You'd pass out before you reach 10,000 hours. You don't got the heart for it. You don't have the stamina for it. You couldn't take what it really takes. What makes y'all stop, or what makes y'all tired, or what makes y'all angry, or what makes y'all frustrated? I'm just thinking if the slaves would have made it with this mentality that we have today. They was walking, y'all talking about, man, we got it hard while you on your Uber app. Let me get that. Man, I'm having a rough day, bro, I promise you. They out here killing me. Yeah, I did. Boom, address, yeah, boom. All right, yeah, he'll be in 5 minutes. Let's keep complaining until my man get here. You Ubering, you ordering, like you complaining, you ordering Chipotle for you before you get there. You didn't place your order walking in like, I can't believe it's just, they killing me. That's me, let me get that real quick. So all I'm saying is like, I'm not against you. I'm here because I love you and I want to see you succeed and I believe you can. But how do you learn four or five languages in 4 years? Because you have to. I just want you to get to a point where you work so hard that you can't get played.